of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Today, our body was Mass for Denise Fulton on the occasion of her birthday. Congratulations. I'm also offering this Mass for the Lawrence and Hoffman families for special intentions, for the Dallas Lucy Tetra for Thanksgiving, for George Kessler, Anastasia Kessler, Hilary Twine, Clark Twine, and also for all the souls of virtue that they may rest in peace. And today we celebrate the feast of the chair of St. Peter. Now that might sound a little bit strange, how can we celebrate the chair? Well, in this case, it's the symbol of Pope's authority. And the word cathedral comes from the word chair. In Greek, the word chair is capital, so cathedral comes from capital, and that is the bishop's church, and the chair is the sign of his authority. So that's what we're celebrating today, the special authority of the Pope. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And let us sing Gloria to the fourth. heaven has set us apart on the rock of the Apostle Peter's confession of faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
And Jesus answered him,
Blessed are you, Simon Bar Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades shall not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Today's feast commemorates Christ choosing Peter to sit in his place as the servant authority of the whole church. After the last weekend of pain, doubt, and self-torment, Peter hears the good news. Angels at the tomb say to Magdalene, "The Lord has risen. Go, tell his disciples and Peter." John relates that when he and Peter ran to the tomb, the younger outraced the older, then waited for him. Peter entered, saw the wrappings on the ground, the headpiece rolled up and placed by his side. John saw and believed, but he has a reminder. They did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. And they went home. Then slowly exploding, impossible idea became reality. Jesus appeared to them as they waited fearfully behind the locked doors. "Peace be with you," he said, and then rejoiced. The Pentecost event completed Peter's experience of the risen Christ. They were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to express themselves in foreign tongues and make bold proclamation as the Spirit prompted them. Only then can Peter fulfill the task Jesus had given him. "Once you have turned back, you must strengthen your brothers." He at once becomes the spokesman for the 12 apostles about their experience of the Holy Spirit before the civil authorities who wish to quash their preaching, before the Council of Jerusalem, for the community of the problem of Ananias and Sapphira. He is the first to preach the good news to the Gentiles. The healing power of Jesus in him is well attested. The raising of Tabitha from the dead, the cure of the crippled beggar, people carry the sick into the streets so that when Peter passes, his shadow might fall on them and cure them. Even a saint experiences difficulty in Christian living. When Peter stopped eating with Gentile converts because he did not want to wound the sensibilities of the Jewish Christians, St. Paul said to him, "I oppose him to his face because he is clearly wrong." "They were not on the right road in line with the truth of the gospel," St. Paul said. At the end of John's gospel, Jesus says to Saint Peter, "Amen, amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you wanted. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands, and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go." What Jesus said indicated the sort of death by which Peter was to glorify God. On the Vatican Hill in Rome, during the reign of the Emperor Nero, Peter did glorify his Lord with a martyr's death, probably in the company of many Christians. There is a story that St. Peter had gone to Rome, and he was leaving the city to escape. And as he was leaving, he saw Jesus come walking towards him. And Jesus said to Peter, "Cloudwise, where are you going?" St. Peter realized he had to go back, and he did, and he suffered his martyrdom. Second century Christians built a small memorial over his burial spot. In the 4th century, the Emperor Constantine built a basilica, which was replaced in the 16th century. Peter described our Christian calling in the opening of his first letter, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead." This saint man's life is perhaps best summed up at his meeting with Jesus after the resurrection, in the presence of the men Peter was to lead. In imitation of Peter's triple denial, Jesus asked him three times, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter answered, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." To mark our celebration of the feast of Saint Peter the Apostle, let us pray with faith and confidence for what we need. Let us pray for the Christian community throughout the whole world, that true to the heritage received from the Apostles, it may remain faithful to the worship of God and the service of all the brothers and sisters. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For the leaders of the nations, that they may be enabled to judge wisely and govern with care for the people in their charge, and in particular for the poor. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For all who are engaged in care of the infirm and handicapped, that they may generously share Christ's love with those in their care. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
Let us remember all Christians involved in the medium of communications. May their voices echo that of Christ, and may the images they project promote understanding and not prejudice. Lord, hear us. Our thoughts turn too to those who suffer for their faith. May the example of the apostles be their inner strength in every crisis. Lord, hear us. Let us pray that the newly founded parish communities in our country, South Africa, may draw inspiration and hope from the memory of the infamous churches nurtured by the apostles. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
our God, may the life of St. Peter inspire us to greater endeavor in the service of your people, and may our lives be abundant in good works through Jesus Christ. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your roots have received bread of you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your roots have seed divinely on you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty
Father.
Accept the favor, O Lord, we pray, the praise and offerings of your church, that with St. Peter as her shepherd, she may come to an eternal inheritance, for it is through his teaching that she holds the faith in its integrity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, all you eternal shepherd, do not desert your flock, but through the blessed apostles, and the foremost and powers of heaven. We sing the hymn of your glory as the part heaven be and all saints of peace throughout the ages. We acknowledge each other as we serve one another. And I place the glory upon you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
I raise it as if you were already there, and in my
myself wholly to you. Never let me be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.